For those of you who didn't think it could get any worse, well, it would get worse today. Due to one specific event. Something involving something pale. I was gonna take on the White Knight. Something which devastated one of our rivals. Specifically the one that tried to tap into hell to generate energy. All I need to do is wait for that abnormality to count down the Quiphoff counter. Yeah. One for every 90 seconds that passed. Time is energy. Well, I'd say money, but what's money in this facility? In fact, energy is what the little Red Riding Hooded mercenary and the rabbit team get paid. Oh yeah, and the requirements for passing this day, whip off level 6 and energy refine, you think? That's easy compared to the previous day. Believe me, it ain't. There's good reason for why it ain't. But I didn't want to speak of it just yet. Mostly because it was not relevant. Oh yeah, it's the reason why there were question marks around the works. At the start, works were randomized. Randomized as in, I wouldn't know what they'd do until I, well, started them. I knew I'd need to use Old Lady, Once in Hundreds of Good Deeds, and possibly the Fairy Festival to test them out before, well, let's just say that picking the wrong work with the wrong abnormality, it wouldn't end well. Certainly not with the crumbling armor and the Beauty and the Beast. Yeah, and you can see the department heads' silhouettes and they'd really let themselves go, didn't they? It'd explain what would happen as the day would progress. Yeah, all the ones that go apostle, they were visually accounted for. Thank you. Okay. I've had to reset because this wasn't a good... Well, I failed miserably. So I'll tell you how this works. The Apostle's Garden, White Knight. Well, it'd be unwise to stick around too long because... That scythe instantly kills those that are unfortunate to get in the way of. And they can also grab agents. Oh, and there's no point in trying to kill. For one good reason. White Knight has something painful on his side. The ability to create a pale damage wave. Which would also bring back any apostles which were killed previously. So I did have a possible solution to this. Which wasn't without its flaws. It would involve sending agents to... Yeah, it didn't exactly work out. Involved sending all the agents to attack simultaneously. Oh yeah, time was not on my side. As in, I lost control of the flow of time. Couldn't change it, nor could I set it to my liking. Yeah. Came up with a movement pattern that would be more satisfactory. Yeah, victory is possible, but I highly doubt it'd be without a loss of life. Not just with those that turned apostle. This was possibly one of the... No, this is the most dangerous of all the abnormalities. The reason why I'm saying this? Well, it's because there is a guaranteed death count. Although, once White Knight is dealt with, the apostles kill themselves. Which, unlike the abnormalities that spawn inferior... Oh, sorry. Did I say abnormalities? I meant ordeals. The ordeals that spawn inferior versions of ordeals. Killing this. The White Knight. Doesn't mean you have to get rid of all the apostles to make him stay dead. Oh yeah. And then there's the problem of... the Studio Ghibli acid trip. And to make things worse... the Little Red Riding Hooded Mercenary... breached. Along with the Dreamin' Current, due to a panicking agent. And all I could do was... put him out of his misery. Stop him from causing even more damage. So, I had 3 abnormalities, and thankfully... the rabbit team could take care of him. Well, some anyway. Well, all 3 of them were in the same department. Unfortunately, it overwhelmed the rabbit team. More were dying. I expected. But at least the Dreamin' Current was taken care of. Along with the Little Red Riding Hooded Mercenary. Unfortunately, I'd need to send in my agents to finish the job. And hope they were up to it. And they were, surprisingly. With all that taken care of, I thought it was time to get the agents to resume their positions. And get on with doing the hard part this day. Getting enough works to satisfy the requirements. Although I did check the departments to see how much damage was caused. And Camille disappeared as if she didn't exist. As for architecture, the entire department's wiped out. This was my worst day yet. And what did I get out of it? A long-range, pale damage weapon. That also provided shields, randomly. By the cost of being able to heal. agent, Adam, wasn't he? Caused a lot of damage when he panicked. I wasn't sure how that happened. All I knew was that did happen. Adam needed a test, which works did what as I couldn't work on WhiteNight or the Parasite Tree unless I knew. Those were the ones that truly mattered. And for a process of elimination, I knew which works did what and which works would be best. And surprisingly, repression was repression. At least for this work cycle. Oh, and during this, I decided that it was best to work on the man with smiling bodies and the blue star a little more often. While it was still safe to do so. Oh yeah, I'll be getting to that. Why it would be safe, to do so. Because there was a good reason why it was unsafe. And also why the White Knight's suit was on one of those working in extraction along with the one wearing the Apocalypse bird suit. Yeah, it was called Planning Ahead. A good thing to have during these more difficult last days. You're probably asking, what's different? Well, that come later. The other me had to go through the meltdowns first separately, and then all at once. That's what the upper department heads. I'll go over them when we get to it. Also the trumpet alert system. Oh, and I forgot to have someone take the harder aspiration. That was where the equip off meltdown was located. Yeah, how careless of me. And next was a white dawn. I was not confident about my chances. I knew that with the facility's currently weakened state, it would require, well, all of the agents at once to even stand a chance. Yeah. Desperation was growing. It started with the works being randomized each work cycle, although not always guaranteed. And after level 2, the user interface got pixelated, making it difficult to make certain details there. And I could see that things were much worse than before. If I could see a black fixer. Well, better now than later. As at least the worst of the meltdown effects would not be in effect until later. Nevertheless, I decided it would be best to have all the agents at once. Choice of location, not ideal. But it could have been worse. And I realized where the Quivok meltdowns would appear. In information. Included in the grave of cherry blossoms. And I wouldn't dare work on that because it'd be instant death. Well, it'd be death anyway. I'd need to check which did what before I even thought about working on the... Oh yeah. And for some reason, Muzak was typing into the facility. As if that would make everyone relax easier. Guess what? It wouldn't. And I could see that things were about to get lethal if I didn't deal with WhiteNight. And we already know how lethal that be. Mostly because we've already dealt with WhiteNight, and I'd rather not have that one breach twice in one day. In fact, after this, I'd rather not have WhiteNight breach at all. Oh yeah, Grave Cherry Blossoms will track 5 random agents here. Thankfully, they could be shaken out of it. I just had to locate them and hope that I could get to them in time. Barely avoided death by cherry blossom. And there was still the rest of the day to take care of. Yeah, I wasn't sure about which did what, so I needed to be sure. And I couldn't. Let the day progress without having the upper lefts worked on. Enough to, well, get closer to the energy quota. And it was a good idea to do so before something worse appeared. And it would. Round about when the white moon appeared. And white moon would involve the red and the white fixers. And we already know what they do. Thank you. Master Level 3, Grefoff. The agent's stats were weak. Let's review what's happened so far. It started with randomized works, such as it was with Malkuth's meltdown. The user interface got pixelated, just like the meltdown of Yesoff. And now, it's Hold's meltdown, where the agents were weakened all over, except it wasn't a gradual build-up. It was straight to the worst of it. Yeah, you guessed it. Medak is next. But that could wait until the fixes were taken care of. The white fixer was easy. I just have to remember not to attack her while she's holding up her weapon. Mostly because if I did, the damage would be reflected back. At least test the different works, and also have someone work on WhiteNight and Paris entry to keep them satisfied. Yeah, much like the fiery bird that you ever meet over. White Knight's weapon needs you to defeat it in order to claim it. Oh yeah, and the Apocalypse, which is much easier to deal with. Well, certainly easier. Yeah, I'll deal with WhiteNight. Sorry, did I say WhiteNight? I deal with the Red Fixer eventually. I decided it'd be easier for, well, more convenient anyway, to let the Red Fixer come to me. Mostly because I can attack from a position of strength. Well, as much as possible. All things considered. Well, I'd been through the worst of it, but it was not over yet, as there was still the energy quota and the rest of the works to do before this day was over. And it wouldn't be easy.